What's up, I'm Melanie Fiona, and you're checking out Suite 903. I'm originally from Toronto, and my family is from Guyana, so I grew up very West Indian, first generation immigrants to Canada. And growing up in Toronto was a great experience. It's a very multicultural city. You get to meet a lot of different kinds of people, and you get to really keep your heritage and your culture as to what it is. So, you know, I grew up with my parents listening to all traditional music, cooking traditional food, and, you know, having lots of friends and people in my life who share the same culture. So it was very live. I loved it. Grew up in a house full of music. My dad used to play in a reggae calypso soul band. So there was always music in my house, whether it was my mom or cooking food in the kitchen in the mornings, blasting music, or my dad at rehearsals. Music was a big part of my family and our heritage. So I think when it came to music and singing, when I was a baby, I couldn't actually go to sleep without Whitney Houston in my crib. Like, my mom, she would have to blast the radio for me to go to sleep. And my dad would play on the guitar. He'd play The Greatest Love of All, and I was about 2 and a half, almost three, and I was singing along when the song switched key. I switched key, and you know, I guess I figured out right there I had a love for music. And when, you know, in my school days, treasures books, and when people would ask me what I wanted to be, I guess I would always say I wanted to be a singing nurse. I don't even know what that meant, but maybe subconsciously I just love music and wanted to make people feel better through it and make me feel better, and I thought that it, maybe it was just something healing to me from that. The album's entitled The Bridge, and it came to me to name the album that because the music is, I feel, a real bridge of everything. It's bridging the gaps between the age groups, ethnicities, genres. And it is what it is. It's a little of everything you've heard, something old, something new. And if I could collectively call it something, I would say maybe it's an alternative soul. I actually wrote on Rihanna's second album, I think, Girl Like Me. It was her sophomore album. It was a song called Them Haters. And I wrote for her. I've written with people in Toronto, and currently, you know, in my publishing situation, I'm going to be writing with a bunch of great songwriters and having the opportunities to work on other artists and, you know, explore different genres that I probably never even embarked on writing. And that's the beauty about writing. You can kind of take it wherever you need to go. Generally, I try to think about experiences that I've been through, obviously, and sometimes I just get inspired by people. I get inspired by things that I see and hear, especially traveling and working on this album and meeting so many different people and hearing people's stories and seeing what other people have to go through and what their struggles are. It really inspires me to make music that speaks to people. So I kind of just try to keep it as real as possible. And make it very visual so people can really see and feel the story, even if they haven't particularly gone through it, but they understand it. When I want it, you gotta be.